Are some numbers more interesting than other numbers? And I think they are.
So like an interestingness rating.
Yeah, I think there are. In the following sense, there's actually a paper about this. So the numbers that are the most interesting are the small numbers. Now, this might be counterintuitive because obviously there are large numbers that are interesting, like Google, Graham's number, Googleplex. Obviously, I'm talking about the videos that I've made. So there are big, interesting numbers. But there's actually a theorem, sort of a theorem, it's a joke paper, by a guy called Richard Guy, who's a pretty well-known mathematician. And he's tried to formulate the strong law of small numbers. And what he says is that small numbers are too interesting, as in they're sort of, you know, there's just not enough of them to cope with the demands that are put on them, essentially. Now, why is this? Why does he say this? He says, well, basically, you look at small numbers and you look at sequences of small numbers, and you can be tricked. You can be tricked into seeing patterns which then don't extrapolate to very large numbers. Or the converse of that, you can be tricked into seeing things that don't happen, which actually, you know, maybe sort of, you know, some characteristic behavior. You can be tricked into seeing things that don't happen, which actually, when you go to very large numbers, it might be some sort of generic behavior. But looking at the small numbers is just not enough. And he's formulated this in this paper here, The Strong Law of Small Numbers. And it's a great little paper. It's just quite a fun paper to look at. What he does is he comes up with a bunch of examples that sort of back up his claim. It's done tongue-in-cheek. In fact, he says this is proof by intimidation, which is, I think, is a brilliant line. But anyway, I thought it was worth looking at some of his examples to see how small numbers can trick you into drawing erroneous conclusions. So the first example is he looks at numbers of the form 2 to the 2 to the n plus 1. Okay, so if I put n equals to 0 in this, okay, then that's 2 to the 0 is 1, 2 to the 1 is 2, plus 1 is 3, so I would get 3 out. Okay, if I put n equals 1 into it, well, you can check, you get 5 out. If you put n equals 2 into it, you get 17 out. If you put n equals 3 into it, you get 2, 5, 7. For n equals 4, you get, well, this number. Okay, so, you know, we're going through. These are a bunch of small numbers, smallish, starting to get quite big now. And what do you notice about all these? Well, they're all prime. Okay, so no less than Fermat thought that perhaps all numbers of this form would be prime numbers. But of course, along came Euler, probably the greatest mathematician of all time, and actually went the next one up, n equals 5. So we go to n equals 5. So 2 to the 2 to the 5 plus 1 turns out is equal to 641 times 6, well, some big number, right? So Euler was able to show that this was true. So this pattern that seems to emerge at the small numbers is just, you know, when you get big enough, it just disappears. So it's sort of the small numbers have tricked you. There's another example that just picking them out pretty randomly. Another one I liked was this sequence. Okay, again, they're all related to prime numbers. Number theorists love prime numbers. Number 31, clearly prime. 331 is also prime. 3331 is prime. 33331 is prime. You can see where we're going with this, right? Carry on like this. These are all prime numbers. So does that mean if I take a bunch of threes and then a one, it's a prime number? Well, you keep on going, and it looks like they are until you hit eight of the threes. If you take eight threes, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 1. So this is the first one not to be prime, and this has been shown to be equal to 17 times 1, 9, 6, 0, 7, 8, 4, 3. So again, small numbers tricking you into being something that they're not. So small numbers are almost too interesting. And yeah, all numbers are interesting, especially the small ones.
5,500,000,000,000, da-da-da-da, prime is... It actually gets a better result the bigger the number is.